I'm joined now by the SNP MP Stephen Gethins. He's the party spokesman on Europe at Westminster. Nigel Farage, of course, is still with us as our guest of the day. Stephen Gethins, the polls at the moment for In Out, they're closer than the polls were for In Out in the Scottish referendum.
Yes, yeah.
Does that put Mr. Farage, UKIP, in a stronger position for this referendum?
The first thing, I mean, they're closer south of the border, north of the border, obviously. There's quite a significant majority in favour of remaining in the European Union. Yeah, I mean, one thing that happened that was quite interesting in the independence referendum, many interesting things happened, but one of them was the way that the gap between yes and no closed over the final 6 months of the campaign.
Because it had been much wider in favour of the union.
It had.
In the spring of last year.
And what was interesting was as we got closer and closer, some people might argue that just after George Osborne's intervention, they started to get a lot closer. But that's one I'll leave to the pundits. But the polls did get a lot closer. I think as people focused on the arguments and really interrogated the arguments as well.
Did you ever dream there would be this incredible bounce having lost the referendum?
Did I think I'd be here today, Andrew? Is that what you're asking?
Well, I suppose that's a personal way of asking
it. A personal way of asking it. No, I mean, if anybody had said we're going to have 56 MPs out of 59, I don't think if there's anybody out there who did think we're getting 56 out of 59, they're not here anymore because they would have won a great deal of money at the bookies.
Indeed, that's right. They'd be in the Caribbean.
We didn't see it.
You didn't see it. If you lose the referendum,
yeah, we're not going to lose the referendum.
No, but if it's conditional, if you do. Is there any chance of a UKIP bounce similar to the SNP bounce?
Anything on quite the same scale would be virtually impossible. And John Curtis made the point that, you know, the SNP led and dominated and were alone in that Scottish campaign for their side of the argument. UKIP's position is perfectly clear, but there will be Conservative and Labour and other figures advocating we leave the EU. So, of course, it won't happen in the same way. However...
there was a broader campaign for independence in Scotland. SNP were core.
But politically...
The Green Party, Labour for Independence. You know, there were some very significant voices outside the SNP.
Politically, it was dominated by the SNP, very, very clearly.
Is it a weakness that you won't have... that your campaign won't be dominated by one major force?
Well, let's see what happens between now and the referendum. You know, there are going to be all sorts of voices advocating leaving the EU, probably more right now than anybody can even imagine. Who knows, maybe even some in the cabinet, you know. Let's see. But I think this, don't underestimate the ability of a referendum to potentially realign and change British politics, not Scottish politics, but the rest of the UK. You know, that 75 referendum, the Labour Party were never reconciled after it. The SDP breakaway in 1981, which led to a completely different kind of Labour Party, ultimately under Tony Blair, really was those who had won the referendum but couldn't accept the fact their own party hadn't changed. And I think there may well be, after this referendum, a lot of traditional Conservative and Labour voters who feel that the inside won but did it so dishonestly.
Have you got any tips for them?
No, I mean, there was a thing that was very important.
Oh, he's fathering.
During the independence referendum, and actually this is where it was much broader than the SNP. And who knows what will happen? We're at the very start of this referendum campaign. But there were trade unionists coming out, academics coming out, the civic groups. It was a very organic campaign. And I think that was positive. People who argued for yes and people who argued for no. I think the politicians had a role, but actually the referendum debate went much further than that. And that's what contributed, after all, to having such a big turnout, which...
If England was to vote to leave, and Scotland, when you add up the purely Scottish votes, it had voted to stay in, but overall would have to vote to leave under the UK referendum, is it without doubt that you would want a second referendum on independence?
Well, let's see what happens. I mean, it's something that the First Minister's talked
about.
I'm giving
you a possible scenario.
Let's see what happens. I mean, look,
the polls were still against you.
Andrew, we tried to prevent this situation from happening by building in a double majority, but that was rejected by the House of Commons.
I understand.
But shouldn't we rephrase the question? Because the British referendum...
Don't go there again.
Hang on a second. The referendum is on Britain becoming an independent country from the European Union. So your referendum would be against independence, wouldn't it?
Well, not really.
No, I'd enjoy seeing that.
I'm looking forward to the final 20 seconds for the final
referendum about being a full member state of the European Union. There was a lot of support for that.
Under which you cannot be independent.
Let's not go there.
Under which
we've only got 5 seconds now. We'll leave this for another.
It's not 5 hours.
Come back and we'll talk about that next time. Thank you.